three games, would have to again come up big in a furious overtime period.
Michelle Samuelson comes up with it. Samuelson's pass off Sweeney, but it comes to Yager down the right wing. Moving to the Bruins in. Inside, go to the slot area. Has a chance. Shoot, scores! The Penguins win in overtime! As Jaromir Jagr shot it, it might have been deflected in, but the Penguins have won 4-3.
For Pens fans who've seen his brilliance, he is a junior Mario. In Game 2, the battered Pens got an enormous shot of sunshine as their leader, Captain Mario Lemieux, surprised everyone by appearing with a mending fractured hand. Despite the heavy bandages, he took control of the game.
Lemieux has it again for the Penguins. Comes in, put it in front. Jagr can't get it. Stevens will try. Have it, Lemieux. Hey!
Shouts and scores!
He finished the evening with two goals and an assist in a 5-2 win. The Pens were beginning to step into their playoff rhythm. With Mario, they now appear to dominate with a 2-0 lead. Most of the Pens grew up in the hinterlands of northern Canada. They learned to play the game on frozen ponds. For Kevin Stevens and several other Penguins, the city rinks of Boston were their field of dreams. In Game 3, Kevin Stevens would play in front of his family and friends in a rink where he played high school and college hockey, the Boston Garden.
Ramming back into the Bruins in. Lemieux around one man. Drop past the Jagr in front. Now score! Kevin Stevens! Francis got the puck, though, and it goes to Tocchet. Back behind the net to Ronnie Francis. Francis in front. Shot by Stevens. He shoots and scores! And sent ahead on the right wing to Tocchet. Out of Lemieux. Bursting back into the Bruins. And he gets more. Put him right in front of Stevens. Looking for the hat trick. He shoots and scores! He gets the HD! And the Penguins lead 3-0. Oh, goal! Arnold Slick from Turtle Creek. Lemieux to Stevens, and he's got the HD with 4:57 left in the first period.
He exploded with a natural hat trick in the first period, and he wasn't finished.
Looking, goes to Lemieux. Will he shoot it? No, it was time. He shoots and scores! Kevin Stevens buries it, and the Penguins lead 5-1.
He buried his fourth goal to seal a 5-1 mauling of the Bruins.
I think the guy upstairs took care of me that night. I was coming home and all my friends were there and family. And everybody's excited for a great game.
Game 4 was just like Game 3, right down to the particulars. Only there were different heroes. Jagr scored another mind-boggling goal. But the night's main attraction was Mario Lemieux, leaving the game's best defensive player in his vapor trail.
Lemieux steals and he's up against Raymond Bork and Adam Oates. Coming to the Bruins, he got around both big, cutting for the net, he's still on goal. Hey! Johnson scores! What a goal by Mario Lemieux! Out! Call Arnold Slick from Turtle Creek. What a goal by Lemieux.
And the Penguin bench is giving him a standing ovation right now. If they didn't have sticks in their hands, they'd all be clapping. They love that. They're standing up on the bench. Lemieux went right after Bork, who had to turn around to get up speed, and Lemieux knew that, so he stayed right with him, just dragged the puck right between his legs and walked in, deked a couple times on Andy Moog, got right in tight on him, and went right upstairs. He shoveled that puck up underneath the crossbar.
Just like Game 3, it was a 5-1 blowout and the Wales Conference Championship.
The Penguins have won the Wales Conference title for the second consecutive year.
It's a great day.
because the defending Cup champion Pittsburgh Penguins, winners of seven straight, meeting the sizzling Chicago Blackhawks, winners of their last 11. Millions watched via satellite. The Stanley Cup Finals. For Blackhawk fans, this was their year.
Sweet. Chicago in four.
A classic matchup. You're going ugly against pretty. Pittsburgh's going to get beat up. They're going to go home scratched up tonight.
The Blackhawks' full-court press defense was so impressive, they swept favorite Detroit and Edmonton. Ow! With speed and tenacious checking, they suffocated offenses. Game one became a nightmare for Pittsburgh. Chicago was smothering the play before it could develop. If that picture wasn't bleak enough, Chicago goalie Belfour looked unbeatable. The Pens gave up the puck, and Chicago cashed in. They jumped out to a 3-0 lead in the first period. That seemed like an ominous sign of things to come. But late in the first period, Phil Bourque had seen enough.
In the center, and he can't do it. It came off a leg. Bourque of the Pens has it. Comes out in front. He shoots and scores! Phil Bourque on the power play goal! And the Penguins make it 3-1!
More pressure and another turnover resulted in another Chicago score to make it 4-1. And for many fans, a funny thing happened on the way to the refrigerator.
Corner to Sean McEachern. Penalty is over. Stan shoots, scores! Pocket might have deflected it in, but the Penguins make it 4-2.
Tocket did deflect it in, and there was more.
Into the Chicago zone. Pulls up and lost the puck. Now we'll get it back. Lemieux has it. Comes down deep. Shooter to Belfour. Goes in! Mario Lemieux uses Belfour like a ping pong ball. He shot it. He caromed off of it. And the Penguins make it 4-3. Oh, no, Eddie. Spaghetti.
Trapped with no one to pass to, Mario the magician faked a look in the crease and banked a shot off Belfour's leg into the net. For those who could see the genius of the play, it is another number 66 goal that will remain in the mind forever. Belfour was beside himself. The strangling Blackhawk attack protected their 4-3 lead throughout most of the third period. Time was running out on the Pens. Tom Barrasso was called upon to make several spectacular saves just to keep the Pens in the hunt. With less than 5 minutes remaining, it happened.
Jager has the puck. Trying to work around Brett Center, does. Comes in around with another man. Comes out the slot, turns with a backhander. Hey! Shoots and scores! Jarmer Jager ties it for the Penguins! Oh, puck him, Dano! A great individual play by 68. The Penguins have tied it at 4.
With absolutely no rehearsal, Mr. Clutch rode his instincts to glory. The Civic Arena was crazy. And when the Pens lined up for a faceoff on a power play with 17 seconds remaining, the unbelievable continued.
They'll drop the puck. It's free. Out right side, Murphy shooting. Same eight rebound on the view. Hey!
The Civic Arena roof must have opened, and the gods smiled. It was as divine an ending as any Hollywood movie. Game one will surely go down as one of the greatest comeback victories in the history of the game. Mario described his gamble on the winning play.